years of extraordinary theatrical experiences. And that's really what it's all about, in the words of the late Wendy Wasserstein.
You know, theater should be a full evening. You laugh, you cry, you get a nice drink at intermission, and you have a full experience.
This is where you come in.
Boston's theater community has nurtured worldwide phenomenons and homegrown classics, just to name a few.
The King's Voice.
The ART's The King's Stag.
We're looking for an offer.
So are we.
Six characters in search of an author.
For a man called, can't think of the name of the man.
Waiting for Godot.
If you loved me as you say, why did you abandon me?
The Serpent Woman.
At least I have one thing left to amuse myself with.
Thank goodness, and what is that?
My pistols, of course, George.
At the Huntington Theater, Hedda Gabler.
I uncovered my breast, and on it I saw the rose tattoo of my husband.
The Rose Tattoo.
You got a real good grip?
Yeah, I got it. Come on, lift up.
All right, ready? Lift!
And the debuts of several award winners from August Wilson.
I just turn away from the awards toward the typewriter and continue to do the work because that's where I get my joy from, is in the actual writing.
All the Christmases roll down toward the two-tongued sea like a cold and headlong moon.
At the Lyric Stage, from A Child's Christmas in Wales to...
But Father, oh no, he loves me.
I know he does not.
To The Heiress.
Sunday in the Park with George!
And Sunday in the Park with George.
I'm going to make you gallop, and believe me, you've got some galloping to do.
We watched Philomena at the Merrimack Rep.
Get under the towel!
Park Your Car in Harvard Yard at the Gloucester Stage.
Jane came home from work one morning, and she found her husband in bed with the milkman.
Tina Packer's Shirley Valentine at the Charles Playhouse.
John,
huh?
It's all right.
Felicity Huffman in Cryptogram at the C. Walsh Theater, and William H. Macy in Oleana at the Hasty Pudding, both written by their friend David Mamet.
To say if you got a bad rap, you have to say, well, would I have changed it had I known before that to have done something differently would have pleased the critic? And the answer is no.
And I knew that night that he would ask me to marry him.
Molly Sweeney at the Nora Theater. Abyssinia at the North Shore Music Theater.
I'll show him a thing or two.
Bat Boy the Musical at the Speakeasy Stage. Sweeney Todd at the New Rep.
I told her I have a credo.
The Credo Canvas at the Zeitgeist.
Approach, Sir Andrew.
The Commonwealth Shakespeare's Twelfth Night.
And you care for me.
Of Thee We Sing at the Public Theater.
Tempest in my mind, the from my senses take no feeling else save what beats there, filial ingratitude.
King Lear at the Actors Shakespeare Project. Cinderella Rocks from Ryan Landry's Gold Dust Orphans.
It feels so right now. It feels so free.
And Sonia Flew opened Boston's newest theater complex, the Stanford Calderwood Pavilion.
A bird came down the walk he did not know I saw. He bit an angleworm in halves and ate the fellow raw.
The legendary Julie Harris was among the fearless actors who took to the stage in solo performances.
You're on your own. Mm-hmm. And it's like being flung into the water for the first time. You say, I don't know how to swim. Well, psh. Go learn.
I think you should know I worry a lot. I worry some of you are here because you couldn't get tickets to what you really wanted.
There was Lily Tomlin in The Search for Signs of Intelligent Life in the Universe.
They knew I was writing this book. I mean, what did they think I was there for?
Robert Morse in True.
Psalms, teeth, psalms, eyes, psalms, text.
Ian McKellen, acting Shakespeare.
Not fooling around at nothing, okay? I'm
just Eric Bogosian, sex, drugs, and rock and roll.
And one of the first people to come by and see me was Reverend Jesse Jackson. And I thought, not this dude.
And Anna Deavere Smith's Twilight Los Angeles.
Hopefully, when people leave the theater, they don't just leave thinking a sense of despair that things are so bad. but actually they leave thinking, I gotta do something.
You and Matthias have a little baby daughter.
Pamela Gein's The Syringa Tree.
The most liberal state in all the land.
Jimmy Tingle's American Dreams.
But I'm a vulture, I wait. Wait, I wait. I watch it, I wait. When it dies, lunch!
Jay Johnson's The Two and Only.
Sunday night was our night to go out to eat for a
Billy Crystal's 700 Sundays.
Oh, hey, this is good.
Julie White's Bad Dates.
Our freedom. Our survival.
Annette Miller's Golda's Balcony.
That's gorgeous.
Dame Edna's Royal Tour.
Still, you wouldn't trade it for a sack of gold. Try me.
Elaine Stritch at Liberty.
We have yet to hear of a mass murder committed with a vibrator.
And Eve Ensler's The Vagina Monologues.
When I started doing the show, it was very therapeutic for me because I was very disconnected from my vagina.
We can do it. We can do it. We can do it with me and you.
Broadway's best musicals have traveled to Boston over this quarter century.
Sometimes I really do get very moved. I said, my God, it's all true. It's all happening. People like it. They're crazy, but they like it.
It's a perfect example of a musical play.
Several Tony-winning musicals worked out their kinks here. My One and Only, La Cage aux Folles, and Dreamgirls.
They should have had a law against apartment houses!
And remember the great stars who graced the Boston boards? Brian Dennehy's performance in Death of a Salesman made Arthur Miller reminisce about the first performances of that landmark play.
Suddenly we were all weeping, and it was magical. Nobody knew why, because it wasn't particularly sad part of the play. But I think we wept because it was so beautiful.
Concrete hallways. Welcome to the friendly roaches, too. Welcome to the pinchers from the stagehands.
There isn't anything like being able to work in the theater and to get an immediate response from an audience to whatever play you're playing. And I don't think there's anything like it.
Welcome to the theater. With some luck, you'll be a pro. You'll work and slave and scratch and bite. You'll learn to kill with sheer delight.
Theater is such a heightened sense of reality, of the moment. It's just the most alive I ever feel.
Welcome to the theater, you fool. You love it so.
You're never really an actor without an audience.
Because the audience gooses you.
It really does. You're off. You're just like that. You can't help it. You know that your eyes are too wide open, but you can't help it. You're so excited.
It was a scream.
It was very funny, yes.
You make me puke.
And as we celebrate 25 years of honoring the best in Boston theater, we look forward to 25 more years of opening nights, and we remember the man who continues to inspire these annual awards.
And I'm so pleased this is being done in my name.
I have tried, as you know, to help theater in Boston as much as I could. And this means to me that some of the work I've done has paid off. These people have come to love the theater, and I love the theater. I'm grateful to them.